There is a speed on deforestation right now happening in Brazil. What would happen if this forest was gone?
Have you been to the Yellowstone Park? You know, have you seen the Old Faithful?
The one
geyser?
That blows the.
Yeah, the trees are green, silent, invisible geysers. Mm-hmm. They are shooting water from the ground up high in the sky. And in doing this, trees cool down the surface. They're like air conditioners. And they shoot the heat, and this radiates to space, and this is very important as a mechanism to cool the planet. So I mean, most people don't realize how important this is.
So in other words, if we lose all these trees, we are losing the air conditioning that cools off the whole planet.
Exactly. Open air conditioning. That's what the forest is. Not only that. No, the trees are soaking up carbon. You know, the pollution that we produce, like carbon dioxide.
Yeah.
Burning gasoline in our cars, you release carbon dioxide in the air, or burning coal. And the trees use carbon dioxide as a raw material. Leaves are like solar panels, very sophisticated solar panels. So you get the sunshine, convert the sunshine in electricity. Did you know that? Electricity.
No, oh my God. So the leaves are like solar panels. This is amazing.
Solar panels.
The leaves are like the most high-tech solar panels.
Unbelievably high-tech. To a point that nobody has ever mimicked leaf the way they do in nature. So when they do this, they produce electricity. Electricity is used to split the water. Oxygen goes to one side, hydrogen to another one. Oxygen is released, that's why the trees produce oxygen for us to breathe. And hydrogen is used as a glue. And it glues CO2 together, 6 CO2 together produce sugar. All the sugar that everybody and every living entity uses comes from this process, converting a pollutant, carbon dioxide, into sugar. That's what the trees do.
I knew that they produce oxygen, but I had no idea that they actually
In the process, they are doing this.
They're the most intelligent being.
Amazing.
So the trees are storing all this carbon. So if you come and cut it down and burn it out, does that mean that all that carbon goes up in the air?
Absolutely.
And that then hits the planet? The whole planet?
Yeah, because the CO2 that was previously trapped in the web of life, in the trees, in the bodies of the trees, in the wood, in the roots, in leaves, is released. Goes to the atmosphere, is affecting everybody. It's heating the planet anywhere and everywhere. But trees, if you burn them, it's not just releasing carbon. No, you're losing an entity that's technological. If you just consider carbon, you are missing the main part of the story. Because the air that's over the ocean has higher pressure. The air over the Amazon, lower pressure. So the wind blows from the ocean inland. So this is like a pump. 97% of all the water on Earth is salty water in the ocean. If you don't pump it inland, then you cannot use it. And that's what the trees do. That's the birth of what is being called flying rivers.
Flying rivers,
exactly.
Okay.
The condensate produces a pump that pumps the wind inland. You know how much water the trees are releasing? Do you have an idea, figure?
No, I have no idea.
Each tree here, a big tree, it releases about 1,000 liters per day.
1,000 liters of water?
Yeah, one tree.
Wow.
If I take all the forest that is left in the Amazon basin, it releases 20 billion tons of water in one day. This is more than the Amazon River. Amazon River discharges 17 billion tons in the ocean every day. And the trees discharge into the atmosphere 20 billion tons.
That's
so
amazing.
This is a lot.
Oh my
God. So this is a lot.
But are you saying that there is more water
flowing right above us
more than the Amazon River, which is the largest river in the world by far.
Exactly.
There is more water than the Amazon River, like on top of us.
Flowing from the trees to the atmosphere. We did the calculation in terms of electricity. The Chinese tree gorges would have to go full power for 145 years to evaporate one day of water in the Amazon. Just one day. So this basically tells you a tale about the disproportion of the effort that humanity would have to do technologically, so to speak.
They couldn't even. It's not possible.
It's impossible.
You can't do the service of the forest. Exactly. You can't replicate the service of the forest.
Well, most colleagues of mine, me included, think it's already too late in the sense of the global story. What is happening in the climate change.
But well, it's too late.
Means we have gone beyond the point of no return. We had...
What are we going to do?
Well, for once, start paying attention to the climate science. Because in the climate debate, what has happened in the last 25 years was just nonsense. Because climate science has been screaming with full lungs for 25 years that the situation was very serious, that we had to act promptly, we had to move.
And why are they not listening to you?
Well, because the dirty industry has funded people to tell lies. Mercenary people who just came forward and say, no, it's not true, no, I have a doubt. And so when the climate starts showing symptoms of the disease corroding this body, the functioning earth, is already advanced. That's why most people I know in climate believe it's too late.
But listen, this can be like, what are we going to do? We have to do something. I mean,
well, 25 years ago, we had a much better chance to avoid
it. I know, but wait a minute. Like, I have children. It's like,
I do.
And
I have a daughter who's 3 years old.
And, so, I mean, what? I mean, we want, I mean.
Well, life on Earth will become tougher and tougher. Hundreds of millions of years ago, the continents were a desert. So nature worked its way on till it built this. So people don't have a clue.
We are in heaven and we don't know it. Like, this is heaven right here.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, on Earth in general, because we have oxygen, we have
food, we have water, we have beauty.
Yeah, and people need to wake up for that reality. It's like when you are in the midst of an unfolding disaster, what do? You panic? No. You move it. Move.
So what would you think would be important? Like, how do you think would be
a solution? Well, first thing, you know, you have plan A. Plan A is business as usual. Keep plundering the resources and using as it were infinite. Plan B is what many people are attempting. You know, changing the matrix of energy and using clean sources. Stop eating too much meat. Diminishing the pressure over the forest and replanting forests. If that doesn't work, then we go to plan C. What's plan C?
I have no idea.
Going to another planet.
No, but we can't do that.
We don't have another planet. So either we'll work with plan B or we're basically
done.
Yeah, we're done. And so
plan B has to work.
And the good news, which doesn't mean that we will fix it overnight, is that nature has incredible technology waiting in the form of seeds. You know, it's just a small capsule, this size, the size of a pill that you take. And there is the information to build a being like that, from scratch, using nothing but water, CO2, and radiation. We can replant, we can recover many of the systems. Why we can? Why we still have some rain on the edges? We can rebuild forests, waiting deforestation. This is no longer enough. So if someone is bleeding, you have to stop the bleeding before you do anything else. So we have to quit deforestation yesterday, not 2020 or 30. But that's not enough. We have to replant. And we can do this.
But we need to spread that knowledge.
Yes, absolutely.
The forest is our guardian.
He's
our protector.
He's
our guardian angel. Like, we don't even know it, but he's here, like...
Yeah, protecting us without we know it. And quietly. Every species of trees has thousands of species of bugs. And also, if you get a leaf of one of those species, and you look to the microbes that is sitting on the top of leaf, you find millions of species, millions. And this is all below our radar screen, so to speak, because we don't realize, it's invisible.
So there's billions of beings in the animal kingdom, in the plant kingdom, all doing a service for us.
Yeah, invisible.
Thank you, forest. Thank you, animals. Thank you, nature.